Brother Rokk, welcome to my bed. Notice something? Notice somebody here? You notice somebody here. Well, let's have a little talk about that, okay? Let me put my shoe on. All right, let's talk about how Garfield got into the bed. All right, now, in my house, no kitty ever was in our beds, okay? Growing up, my first cat, the cat was never allowed in my bed. Never allowed in mommy and daddy's bed because kitties, they get their paws in litter boxes. And they walk around on the floors, which might be dirty, filthy, messy floors. So you don't let them get into bed, right? But, you know, when you get a cat, sometimes you find out that you're not the one who's in control. Okay. And this darling here, we're still getting used to each other. And he's a very interesting guy. Yeah, well, one of the things that I have done to improve the conditions around here is I found a small piece of carpet that was, if not brand new, it was way, 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 way cleaner than what we got going on here. So I took it and I threw it back on the area where I usually do my turnaround in my studio. That's where he likes to plop down a lot. And I figured let him be on there. He'll be nice and clean there. And I figure he can go there, then he can go on the top of the food bucket, and then he can jump back and forth onto my bed. And as you can see, the bed does not have any more clothes on it. It's actually clean, and I decided to open up a sleeping bag, and I had that laid on top of that. And then he started getting on the bed, and then I'm thinking, how do I keep myself clean? And I said, I'll open up another sleeping bag that I'll actually crawl in. So what you see is an all-purpose sleeping bag, and that's the main surface. And he stays that quadrant, okay? He doesn't go up here. I'm still a germaphobe, and so he doesn't go around here. And I hope he doesn't do any bathroom duties on there. I already threw out a laundry basket that had evidence of all kinds of misdeeds. And I just, the things that were in there, the only thing that I saved to wash were these plastic chains. They're white and they're very, very useful. I have one on my set. They're very good for hangers of clothes on and mounting things on. And there were things that my mother had from when she was a Boy Scout leader. So that was being washed. And there are a few other things, but a lot of things just got thrown out. Because, you know, once a cat uses something for another bathroom. Yes, I'm talking about you. Once they do that sort of thing, they're proven that, you know, you got to keep an eye on them. And so we're doing more vacuuming and things. And I'm going to try to find some more little rug things to him for him to get on, because I actually priced, I was hearing how expensive it is to rent these carpet cleaning machines, and I found out I got a so-called good price on one in Amazon, but of course it was only the Amazon Prime price. And then I'm thinking, with my luck with tech, say I get it and this thing is more than 150, right? Then say, because I'm having problems figuring out how to operate it or something, or plus remember that price doesn't include the fluids, you still have to buy the soap that goes with it and stuff. And I would want to really use it, you know, I want to wash all the carpets in the rooms I have control over, and then I would want to wash my mom's carpet, and I want to get the halls in here and whatever, and offer it up to anybody else in my home that needs to use it. You know, I'd be cool about it. But anyway, I'm thinking of other ways to deal with the situation, which is mainly to have clean surfaces for Garfield to get on, so that when he is hanging out, he doesn't transfer the filth to the bed area. I have mopped the kitchen floor a few times, and then I've opened up clean newspapers and put them on areas for him to plop on, because I noticed he is attracted to newspaper. So I have newspaper near the food and water, which I don't keep here in my bedroom anymore. I keep it in the kitchen. So, and I noticed something. I'm going to have to probably put bricks or something to weight down his litter box, because he gets on it a lot of times. He dumps it because he's not a small boy, right? Saying you're not small, right? Aren't you beautiful? Yeah. So I'm still getting used to this cat on the bed thing, but it seems to me that more cat people have them in bed than don't. And I've had people kind of pass judgment on me for not wanting the germs and stuff. But I think that this is a really safe compromise, because since I have my own sleeping bag, I am keeping certain Genji Benjis from kitty paws and other body parts from getting on me. Oh, and this is for sleeping. It is actually, I'll show you what the hair looks like. I'm going to have to take this out soon, so that I can do the roots again and do it all over again. That's probably going to be its own video. But I just wanted to show you the new sleeping situation. And, these plastic, I found this. This is a find. These plastic chest of drawers. And these just have coffee in them. This has regular caffeinated coffee. And this has decaf coffee, mostly packets from the casino hotel rooms. And this is, I think, paper towels or tissues or something. Then I think there's sheet protectors in there. So, but anyway, this is the coffee thing. And my Garfield. Oh, and I gave him the application of that Capstar. And hopefully no more miserable kitties. All right, I will talk to you tomorrow. I should go back to bed now. Okay. See?